Good morning and ngadru dili da samaro du. Oh yeah. Ane da din de. Aj kanjo chen de ni sa da ji pebe. Culture center. Di tholya, di nalolya. Thoma yong age. Kogab sambu chungbe de. Marai gawishra chung. An dēdā lēngi dōng ārā dzū pūrī dā bīndā māngbōchī dī chōgān dī nā rē, chōgān shindā nā rē yōb chē dā gāng dzū jā gī kōgab chōngbō dē liā an dā rī Canada liā yōng gī dā jī gōdēn dzū rū jī dī ārā dzū jī pūrī bīndā sō tūrē yōng ārā bōchī dīne jīgī mī yūrū tū shāngbirē, dīne yūrū sāne ān dīne jīgī tūrē chūngā kōgab sāngbō chūngbō tēlē ān kāwā shirā chūngs ān dā nā shīngī yā mī rī shindā māngbō chūtū ān kia ān sāngbō rō lē nā tē tē shīng ān dīne dē jīgī tūrē chūngbō tēlē kāwā shirā chūngs shūyā yīng No, not yet. Maybe you need to switch on.
Testing 1, 2.
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. It is my great delight to be here with you at the Tibetan Canadian Cultural Center. It's wonderful to have this chance to have my first visit here in the context of my first visit to Canada and to be together with the members and leaders of the center as well as the members of the Tibetan community. Actually, meeting together with Tibetan people who are living in Canada was one of my main goals of visiting Canada, and therefore I'm very happy that this opportunity has come to pass and that we can all be together in this way, in person. And furthermore, there are many other peoples who are represented here today and gathered here today. And equally, I would like to express my delight at the opportunity to be together with everyone who is gathered here. Welcome to all.
It's not working, that one, another one? No? Somebody can help.
I'll use this one.
Okay.
Maybe this one's just recording.
Okay. That didn't they show me Madre Chalea? An lo zhong ci ge ma, zhi xie wo le song du. Da, lo zhong ci ge ma de, an ka zang ye jia, long zhen liya, yin ji ge zi long zhen liya zhe ge liya, an di du zan ta xie bu de. Dring du zi dring yang ga, an lo zhong ci ge ma de, xie guai chi du san da ka sang wu ma ge ni zui di ma ji recalling lu ji qi den lu qi yong du de ni da ni ka sang ra nga pe ge de be ge li ya manchester li ya de ji ma mo ke do ru chung ji de mi ni ju zhen yi zi chong bu le wo ne xie bi na
The topic for this morning's talk will be the text called The Eight Verses of Mind Training. And actually, I had the opportunity to share some teachings about this text in London, the capital of the United Kingdom, when I recently visited there, not too long ago, just in the recent passing weeks. And therefore, since I'm teaching this morning on the same text that I taught in London, it naturally makes me remember London and remember what it was like to be there. While I was visiting London, as we all know, there was a terrible tragedy in Manchester, England, in which 22 people lost their lives and many more were injured. So of course, when I was initially making plans to visit the United Kingdom, I thought that some of this would entail some leisure time and some nice, pleasant sightseeing outings and so forth. But after the tragedy happened in Manchester, my security team wouldn't let me go out very much, so I ended up staying inside a lot. So it happened to be the case that in India, I spend a lot of time staying inside, and then during my visit to the UK, I spent a lot of time staying inside. So even though there was that difficulty, my heart still went out to the people who were affected by the Manchester tragedy. And I was thinking continuously of the suffering they experienced in body and mind. And now, as we have heard in the news this morning, tragedy has once again struck the United Kingdom with the incident in London that has taken lives and caused injury. And so I just wanted to note that my thoughts and my heart is with the people of the United Kingdom and everyone affected by this tragedy, and that I am keeping them in my prayers.
Lungo di dagi gosa maru le yang ji gosa da ji xian na. Lungo ji zu ai yu song lu ge xian la. Lungo di jiam ju na ro na. Tar lo zong si ge ma di. Kyo xin xin bo lo ri tambi zebi lo zong si ge ma di. Shuvar chevalya, dachi lozhong tsigyema, dachi tsig, sholoka geyebimre. Sholoka gebo di, enji sholoka riri, dachi lozhong genyamle riri, dungyebimre.
The text that we will explore is called The Eight Verses of Mind Training, and as the title indicates, the text possesses eight verses. Each of these verses points out a specific practice for training our minds.
ta gi she lang ri thang ba di kon lu gyu ta ji zeba bo lo jong di zeba bo ki she lang ri thang be lu gyu ru ji ta bo shu gwa ar ju do de ta yi ne ya mi se da dri di tu ju ske me bi yin za ma bo shu mo wa che ta kong gi ji ge she lang ri thang be ko she yin ju sa ne ta ji kong da ji kashmo da ji yo ko le ya ji ji mi se mi da ra da kar re sa na ane ji kong gi she re de na bo shu ju so na bo se du sa ka to na bo gi ji ma re da ji lang ta ngo na ba se du sa na she re de ane ka du yi ne ji na bo ru ji shu ga re su de in ji ge le ya series so ma re de ji ji shu ga re su je da di gyun zen de ne ane lang ta ngo na ba che che and that ji gajwe shuar bu tinji chungi mere.
The author of the text was the great Kadampa master Geshe Langri Thangpa, and so it would be suitable at the beginning of our discussion to say a few words about the background of the author of the text, but due to our limitations in time this morning, we won't have time to go into detail regarding his life story. But to say a few words in brief, Geshe Langri Thangpa was a master from the Kadampa tradition, and one of his most well-renowned traits is that he was said to have a very serious and somber demeanor, and he was said to wear a very serious and somber expression on his face all the time. And so he came to sometimes be called by the nickname Serious Lang Thangpa or Somber Lang Thangpa.
Jeza Dingsa, Pepen Nalo Lea Shunge, some of that, Pepen Shunge Gitamatakana, Pepen Nalo Lea Chi Mikashegi. Anji ta su gyung ge nam be ge de ru som ne te le ang ga ba ge de ga ba ge du sa ne ran ju ji be ka shu ji be zhen xia ru ji de lang tang ge xi le de tang ba be zhen xia sa de de ge xi le de tang ba ti be ge du yi ne be dong ba na wo chi ge ya zhe de de yo le shi san bu ji bu zha ne yo le shi da 去年前呢，那没大把的，冬天的，这天刚上了大街，你们大把的是，这都冬天天刚上了大街，那这就不咋的了嘛，这些男的他们的，那呢，可别说出去了，这些人的，用的有啥？
These days, there are some Tibetans who are trying to refute some of the practices of traditional Buddhism, some of the traditionally held views of Buddhism. And in their endeavor to refute the validity of traditional Buddhism, they invoke the example of Geshe Langri Thangpa and his somber expression that he is famous for wearing. And they say, this Geshe Langri Thangpa always had such a serious, sad-looking, somber face all the time. And this shows that he wasn't happy at all in his mind. And they say that this itself shows that the Dharma just makes people miserable. They say that Dharma teachings are all about emphasizing impermanence, emphasizing suffering, and just thinking about bad things every single day. And so they emphasize the example of Geshe Lang Ri Tangpa to try to prove this point.
Dine, Gora, Geshe Lang Ri Tangpa, Shengon, Nabashi, Shua, Di, Koran, December, give me a visit. Chigorba, the Koran be, my give you, she was his take, and she and Nabashi should ever see. Marison. That's all the answer, she be, and them june, Lagatin, Cheve, Goblia, Susie be, Jigwood Dim. And Jigbe, lots of dim chair, the sun, or John Shinki, and Taji, Kashore Tombate, Jig Tombeki, Jig Master Summer, Taji, Tombeki, Shat, Shedim, this or Magic, Kuru, Be, Kashore Taji, Dimiunwa, Tambor Chaiwa. And these were the Jet, Gisilan Tambe, Nimatawa, and Jig, Simjing, Shendian Cha.
来别公布自己都写写公布能点写写书也不印章第一军山的点呢俺们说是写的这是 Ledun Telea, Ribotsiji to Timbuk, Yanji Tis Tomba, Chicambor Sue Devati, Pata du Chibuina, Tundakar Benangazu Sim Gadu Michu Shodua Samba Jovacha to Michu Shoda. That Michu Koran and Dig Korang when a shena, that the Sim Gadu Tambi Michu race. This same Jove called Tambi Michu is Yavacha Kalahabrova. That in a cranky, she Michu, Yuaki, Kumzens and Abrado. Yanaji, cranky, Puki, Sambe, Nangi, Kran, Kashu, the Swanar of the Kachat. She's a Dijuzen then. Lantang one of us, Lapa Juzendi, Kongji Simjin Shendu Chach, Chanju Senda, Chamnizilla Soviet, Yamnin Titelape. Nende,
However, I think that the somber expression that Geshe Lang Ri Tangpa wore on his face was not an expression of misery in his heart, but rather it was an expression of his one-pointed focus on the welfare of other sentient beings. So whenever we have to concentrate, I think it's common for all of us that our facial expression changes. When we have to concentrate really one-pointedly on whatever activity it might be, it's natural for the muscles in our face to tighten and for our face to look very serious. So, in the same way, Geshe Lang Ri Tangpa focused very intently very one-pointedly on the welfare of other sentient beings every single day and was continuously extending his best effort to help other sentient beings out of heartfelt concern for them. That is why his outer expression appeared to be so serious. So, on the surface of things, it looks like a stern expression, but in terms of what's really behind that, it's not really stern or somber or anything dark. It's like the example of crying. When our hearts and minds feel sad, sometimes we cry and we shed tears. Yet on other occasions, when we're overcome with joy, sometimes we also cry and shed tears. And if we look at these two instances of crying, we can see that sometimes it's difficult to differentiate them just by the way a person's face looks. The tears don't look different, and sometimes the facial expressions also look very similar. So if you just see someone's face who is crying, if you don't know what has happened, maybe it would be difficult to tell immediately whether they're crying out of sadness or crying out of joy. In Geshe Langri Tangpa's case, his heart was filled with bodhicitta, the wish for awakening, and with loving kindness and compassion for all sentient beings. And out of this great love and compassion for sentient beings, he was continually focused, one-pointedly, on accomplishing the benefit of other sentient beings. And that one-pointed focus is what led to the expression on his face that appeared to others to be somber. And so, because of this facial expression, he was given the nickname Somber Lang Tangpa. But the real reason behind the expression was not a somber attitude.
A lot of people have made remarks to me about my facial expressions. Especially foreigners have often said to me, "You always look so serious." And even many Tibetans have observed this as well. They have told me, or I've heard it said, "Oh, Karmapa is always so serious and somber all the time. I think the next time he smiles will be when Tibet gains independence." But in any case, Geshe Langri Tangpa's serious facial expression and my serious facial expressions are completely different. When I look at pictures of me or videos of myself when I was younger, when I was a child, I see that I smiled quite a lot. But as I grew older, my facial expression became more and more serious all the time. As I grew older and my difficulties increased and the problems that I had to face increased and increased, then the frequency of my smiles seemed to decrease and decrease. So previously, when I was younger, things were more spacious. I maybe had a hard time with my studies, but apart from that, there weren't too many great difficulties. But later on in my life, the difficulties and problems and so forth got bigger and bigger, and my smile faded away more and more, and then I ended up as someone who doesn't smile very much. The first verse of the 8 verses of mind training is a verse that teaches us the practice of training our minds in cherishing all sentient beings in general. It teaches us to deeply value all sentient beings in the same way that we would value a wish-fulfilling jewel.
对不对呢？当你心间常见了一心无念了，全受诸边三昧，大度戒不怎么说说。The
verse says, thinking of all sentient beings as being more precious than a wish-fulfilling jewel, with the intention of achieving the supreme goal, may I at all times hold them dear to my heart.
当你 干的是老大，这个先接不了这吧？昨天的这先接不了这吧？对了呀，先接进了呀，这个罗江刚说的先接不了这边，什么长这边就不对，那这样。 别人看出来的，他搞不得了，疫情给弄不松了，但疫情给弄不散的，我说我们这家儿给，但是，电视这个，看出来了，这最难的松的啊，别说这些，但第一他抢着我这上不当兵呢，但第三别呢，多些怕了么着，知道吗？ 多少帕拉姆？diamond是什么单位呢？到底咋什么其他的？这个人他什么其他的呀？但一年多少帕拉姆的？他的他们就中共的，再没有呢？那过去，或者是三五了，或者是，定是不休息了，约得不起。那这样子，啥都都这个呗，这药呢约得不起。
等于就是啥呢？当第一年级，他们就上到多少岁的？幼儿园的不低，俺就他们年龄别学习去，再再不学了，俺们这就上就他们就说怕学习，俺大个那就，那我们不是他们的才华，这就学校里呢，俺个怕他们是难吃不如去，这就是用的药来说。
And so this first verse gives us the instruction to train our minds in cherishing others. Train our minds in the attitude, or in adopting the attitude of cherishing other sentient beings. And the example that is used to illustrate this state of mind of cherishing is that of the wish-fulfilling jewel. So I think His Holiness says that the wish-fulfilling jewel is an example that's used as a literary device in the classical treatises of India. This is the origin of this example, is that it comes from the older treatises of India. But if we were to give a more modern example of something that is universally considered to be very valuable, we could look at the example of a diamond. So a diamond is generally something that is considered to be very valuable. But if we look at the process through which diamonds are excavated, we see that they're not pristine, shining diamonds right from the beginning. They have to be searched for through great effort. And one has to dig very deep into the ground to discover the diamond. Once one discovers the diamond, one has to remove all of the earth and other stones that cover the diamond up. Then, having removed the other dirt and stones that cover the diamond up, one engages in further polishing and refining. And then, and only then, you have this precious stone that you can present as a very valuable diamond.
So we were instructed by the mind training text to adopt an attitude towards sentient beings that is similar in quality to an attitude of valuing a wish-fulfilling jewel or valuing a precious diamond. So when we excavate diamonds, they're not just a pure shining diamond from the very beginning. We have to put a lot of work into the process, searching for the diamond, cleaning the diamond, and so forth. And in the same way, when we relate to sentient beings have a basic nature that is good. Sentient beings have a basic nature that is positive. But that goodness and positivity of sentient beings does not shine through clearly in the beginning.
At the outset, our relationship to sentient beings is one in which we see positive qualities mixed with flaws. And in particular, we often see many flaws in sentient beings. Whatever type of sentient being we are related to, whether we are relating to, whether we regard them as low or high. So even though the nature of sentient beings is positive and one of goodness, sometimes it's difficult in the beginning to have confidence in this because we perceive so many flaws. And because the positive nature of sentient beings is obscured by their flaws in the same way that diamonds in the beginning are obscured or hidden by the earth. Nevertheless, if we can continue to relate with sentient beings and endeavor to benefit them, then those sentient beings can become a source of great benefit and happiness for ourselves. And therefore, sentient beings are very meaningful and highly valuable and should be cherished by us. If we continue relating to sentient beings and developing loving kindness and compassion toward them, we will acquire many benefits. In the same way that if we possess a precious stone or mineral or metal, such as silver, if we sell that, then we will get a lot of profit in return. In the same way, if we benefit sentient beings, if we cherish sentient beings, then that will give rise to much benefit and happiness.
The second verse of the text says, "Wherever I associate with whomsoever, may I see myself lower than all the others, and from the depths of my heart, dearly hold others as superior." This verse is teaching us the practice of humbleness and having respect always toward others. It is teaching us that in whatever place we might find ourselves and in whatever company or companionship we might find ourselves, then in all directions, 360 degrees around us, we view ourselves as the one who is lower, and we view all others as the ones who are superior or supreme. We extend this attitude of respectfulness in all directions.
Abby. So, Dangi Kondo, Chirisim Jamzale, Becho, Jebriz, Large. That's some Chiyoni, some of the Duzane, Le Lavruci. Baine, Chadal, Mixucane, Be Kashwadaji, Lalentario, Duzane, and Kalakavruci. Bene, ne, Chadabaji, Kasa Chadabaji, Nyamdo, Droyon Duzane.
The second verse
미소간이 레
The first verse of the text gives us the instruction to cherish sentient beings in general. But this second verse takes the practice to a deeper level and encourages us to relate with specific situations and specific sentient beings with the same amount of respect. And this makes the practice more challenging because it can be quite easy for us to feel warmth and respectfulness toward all sentient beings in general. But it can be quite challenging for us to apply this same attitude to very specific situations and specific sentient beings. So this verse number 2 encourages us to apply this attitude of humility and respectfulness in very specific, special individual situations. And when we do this, it deepens our practice of mind training. So an example to illustrate this need for applying the teachings in a very specific way is that we could talk about covering, if we wanted to cover the heads of everyone in this room. It would be one thing to bring in a big piece of cloth and say, okay, we're going to use this big piece of cloth to cover the head of everyone in this room. You could get that job done fairly easily if you had a big enough piece of cloth. It would be a fairly grand process, but one that would be pretty straightforward in how to accomplish that. But if you were to say, we're not going to cover everyone's head with the same piece of cloth, but we actually have to make a hat for every individual person in this room, then that would be a lot more work. You would have to measure every individual person's head, find out what shape of hat and so forth would be most suitable to them, and so on. So there would be much more effort involved, and you would have to spend a lot more time on that project. In the same way here with mind training, the instruction is that it's not enough to have just a general attitude of benevolence toward sentient beings, but you have to bring this general attitude into specific situations. And you have to spend more time emphasizing the development of this humbleness and respect for sentient beings in very specific cases and in multiple one-to-one relationships.
(coughs)
kibe nga jero cha che rangi member tan xian le jeb de jia de pe zhen xia na du sa ne ya zu ki pe ru xia na ya zu di ane qora sa zhe ma wu liao le sa zhe ma wu liao bi yin zan ane ji sa tuo sa ma ba bi ji chu dang an da ji qar zhu ji zang bu la shao ba de de zang lu ma jia zu le ya pa bu de le oda de ne xin xian ne ge bu de le ya su su le ya men ber da san ne zhang du yin an di men ber da san si su ni ju xie si wo ma le qan da zu zu de ji su su de be ji lu zhu chen ge ne bu ji ya na ji qar zhu le da ji Kacau dah si, simju baru berci, tadi suci baru berci, tadi si insan baru berci, wandering sama lah, wander sama lah, tadi baru berci insan baru berci. Tadi tu je simju sudah suci tu boleh bina, korang simju ni rasa ni, mana suruh ya, lobjong ni rasa ya. Tadi si simju sudah jawab ya, korang si di si kere, di kam si korang ki si mebar ni. Da, dinde ge, minzhe wei wang ge, ngang chang ruo le, lu zhong ruo zha ye de bi, zu xi me. Dinde ge bei yu san di yu san de ne, he du yi ne, dan zhi du ye, dan a be ji ge shu le de ji, be chuo de ge bo de ji yin san san ruo ji dinde ji ge ma jie bi xi qie. Ga da ji sim ji su de su zhuo bei ge le yi ne, da mi se di zha ne, ngang zhu ji ti dan zhe ba qie wei ke du le ya, ko ni zhu zhe min na zuo zhi zhong ge le. 第一圈呢，他说六种年都不如切切。第二个团呢，看到他说，是先了，先给咱呢，可六种这个的也上不了不起，俺那六种先给人上不了不起。第二就上不当去，前面一面呢，俺做了开不上药的，开不上药的，偏到药的。第二就是啥呢？陈旧什么啥的，就什么些了，都不要嘛嘞，什么些了。 不长的叠不起来，现在陈旧身边给，忽然给老总去阿是难找到，老总忽然来，老总叠不长的叠不起，看到了这，他肩膀忙不就整理啊，忽然那边老总收起拿去，那，看出来的是，嗯，嗯这个，陈旧什么事就是啥呢？ 大家看到现在明天不就安的，等你去做的，大家看到就我们卖吧，就先给原店出来了，现在这个都大家看到，就我们卖吧，等你去原店上，第一原店了，等你，那可能，他说的就，可对的，强在的嘛，那可对的就开盘嘛，都强在的，这个要嘛的。
If my speech is long, you should tell.
Oh, no worries, no worries.
Okay. So,
An example that we can look at to illustrate the meaning of this instruction to break down one's own pride and hold others as supreme is the example of the ocean. The ocean always chooses to hold the lowest ground. The ocean is situated on top of the lowest ground of the earth. But because of this low situation of the ocean, then the ocean is able to receive the water of all of the rivers in the world. If the ocean were not situated in a low place, it would not be able to receive all of the river's water. And so, in the same way, we're encouraged to hold a low seat and instead to regard others as supreme. But when we say that we should hold a low seat or regard ourselves as lower, we're not saying that we should engage in self-deprecation. That's not the meaning of holding a low seat. The meaning of holding a low seat is to regard any encounter with another sentient being as an opportunity to learn from them. In this way, we adopt an attitude where we see ourselves as being like a researcher, and sentient beings as someone from whom we can learn. Whenever we meet with any sentient being, that meeting presents an opportunity to learn about a different disposition of a sentient being, a different set of interests of a sentient being, a different constitution or personality of a sentient being. So we should never think that I'm okay in terms of my learning, I've learned enough, and I'm the best. But rather, we can look at our encounters with sentient beings in all of their variety as opportunities to receive more education, more training, more learning about how to benefit others, how to accomplish the benefit of others. If we approach our relationships with sentient beings in that way, then we will receive only benefit, only profit from our relationships with sentient beings, because we'll be learning something new. We will be learning something new every time. So for the bodhisattvas, the fields of learning are limitless in number. There is no end to the training of the bodhisattvas. The bodhisattvas train for eons and eons, learning how to benefit sentient beings. And so this is the attitude that the bodhisattvas adopt, that each opportunity, each encounter with a sentient being is an opportunity to learn more. In this way, the bodhisattvas become insatiable with regard to learning. They take every encounter with a sentient being as an opportunity to learn, and they only want to learn more and more about how to benefit sentient beings. In this way, the bodhisattvas are insatiable. And so for the bodhisattvas, relationships and connections with sentient beings only bring benefit. They do not cause any damage or loss, but every encounter with a sentient being for the bodhisattvas brings benefit. The third verse of the text says, "In all my activities, by examining my mental continuum, and as soon as afflictive emotions arise, which are pernicious to self and others, may I forcefully confront and avert them."
And Kedi Nyomon Keva
통 소나 대베 센터스 봐 베지 가르다지 타고 체지 베 남사 지 가르다지 이미디드 리액션 체지 and the cowardess.
This practice of cherishing others as supreme and regarding oneself as lower is not an easy practice. We find that when we endeavor to engage in this practice, we are challenged by our own disturbing emotions or mental afflictions. The mental afflictions are our biggest challenge to engaging in this practice because it is the mental afflictions that prevent us or try to prevent us from cherishing others as supreme. It is the mental afflictions that try to prevent us from regarding ourselves as lower. Instead, the mental afflictions try to encourage us to regard ourselves as supreme. The mental afflictions encourage us to have pride about ourselves, and they encourage us to regard others as being lower. And so, when our mind is governed by mental afflictions, it's very difficult for us to see others as supreme and ourselves as being lower. Therefore, the instruction given in this verse is that once we notice that a mental affliction or a disturbing emotion has arisen in us, then we immediately and with great force or energy cut the momentum of that mental affliction and reverse it on the spot.
다 뒤지 망고 잘 믿는 제가 망고지 슈랑스 게임스 많아 안 다리 안다 가르쳐야지 지 소수기 템베 장수 쪽은 템베 소 쪽은 다지 텐시 된 소수기 안 되지 가르쳐야지 샘기 내급 샘기 니주르디 난기 니주르디 가르쳐도 와 아 다시 쳐고 그랬어 다시 전에 안다 이제 용모바 계산에 섭사로 총나 코나 마케 코네 안 되지 텁시 당지 지 가르쳐다지 코라 딜레바 독특 텁시 쳐오레스 계산아 갈아가보시오바 마케 코네 계로 치비산 안 텁시 당제 다 대바지 독특 쳐오레스 디 계심 다 인베데 독도 쳐버는 게는 전배기 능균의 전시 땡기지나 그 하고로와 데스 답 야부시라면도 섭섭지 전바 땡기지미나 안고 뇽모 게스디마도 안 다지 뇽모 다 게사레 게사레 섭섭으로 드리지게 에 지게 전반에 투야 갈아 합시다 저 디 균제 된 전시 땡고
The main point here is that we should establish the spy of mindfulness. We should set up the spy of mindfulness or the sentinel or watchman of mindfulness. We should establish vigilant attentiveness over our own state of mind. If we rely on mindfulness and awareness continually, then we will be able to avert disturbing emotions even before they arise. So our awareness will help us to recognize when a disturbing emotion may be about to arise, and then we will be able to engage in methods that will help us prevent that disturbing emotion from actually arising. And that is the best way to avert disturbing emotions. If a disturbing emotion has already arisen in us, then we can apply methods to try to reverse it or relinquish it, but it will be much more difficult by then because it has already come to be active in our minds. And so, if we're someone who continually practices mindfulness and awareness, we will be able to have the insight, oh, a disturbing emotion might arise in this situation, and we will be able to head that off so that a disturbing emotion does not arise. But if we do not have a continual practice of mindfulness and awareness, it will be very difficult to have that type of preparation. And so the disturbing emotions will then arise in our mind stream. So it's very important for us to rely upon mindfulness and awareness in a continuous way. The fourth verse says, when I see beings with unwholesome nature, afflicted with grave sins and suffering, like finding precious treasures, may I dearly cherish them as if they are hard to find. The fifth verse says, when others, out of jealousy, wrongly disparage and slander me, etc., may I take upon myself the defeat and respectfully offer victory to them. The sixth verse says, even if someone that I benefited and had great hope in that person gravely mistreated and causes harm to me, may I view them as a sublime teacher.
In the fourth verse,
We are given an opportunity to practice mind training in relation first to beings of very ill character, and then secondly, in relation to individuals who have committed severe negative actions. Negative actions such as one of the five acts of immediate consequence, or transgressing one's vows and samayas. And the third type of beings that we are, that the this fourth verse relates to, is beings who are being afflicted with very harsh forms, or by very harsh forms of suffering, such as a serious disease. The text says that whenever we encounter a sentient being in any of these three categories, then we regard them as being similar to a precious treasury of jewels. In other words, we regard that situation as representing an excellent opportunity. It is an opportunity for us to practice mind training, and it is also an opportunity for us to benefit others. And so, rather than reacting in our habitual ways to this situation of meeting this particular sentient being, we regard it as an opportunity to accomplish the benefit of others, and we regard it as an opportunity to train our minds further, to practice mind training.
That ne, tsuga ngaba digi. That is shengi, kashwa de jangliya, kuruan de bala soba. Gyun sang jang bala soba, tinje chumbe kato liya, and susugi, jibe kyung kurche, and gyaga shiana deku resum.
In the fifth verse, the text teaches that when we encounter other sentient beings who disparage or insult us, or who reveal our hidden flaws, at that time we should take defeat upon ourselves and offer victory to others.
That's all the damage didn't receive them to do the Shramdo. I guess you love you up your yourself. That the yours, mother, and you are somebody. Jazanta, the Gamoche. That didn't the Gerard Dingy could chonga the Gisela Jay. That didn't do sane. Then Donatu, the end that the Kasu Namju, Azuigi, the Tossa Kasu, the Jimba, the Tsurim, the Sobata, Mangu, the Bezuchewa, Gimzin, the Carlesana, so the Dibuan daya da cho zwa xie de des. Da dibuan daya da cho zwa liya nani la kundib di gajin du xie bi mi na guan di ba di su su gi ga zhu da ji di opportunity zhu ji dibuan daya da cho zwa gi and the cook of the tea, and she go on the Catolia, and Susie Delia, Cantar, Casuetaji, the
dibada da cho cho rangge ji ngne de ne ge da arre rang rang le chu kha khor ji rang rang le chu kha khor ji rang shu da cha en da ji da ne ji ge rang ge nyu mo le su sin cha de ne ge guo ji yin shi ma ji ji xie min na en de yang xue ji shi
Generally speaking, on the path of Buddha Dharma, it is taught that it is very important for us to gather the accumulation of merit and to purify our negative actions. It's taught that the practices of generosity, discipline, and so forth are very important to engage in very extensively. And the Buddha's teachings say that the reason why we need to engage in so much practice of generosity, discipline, and so on is because there is a lot for us to do in terms of purifying all of our negative actions and gathering the accumulation of merit. And so this verse is teaching us that we can actually regard instances of being insulted by others as opportunities to purify our own negative actions and as opportunities for us to gather merit. So if we can use that occasion of being insulted or derided by someone else as an opportunity not to cast blame on the outside, but turn our attention inward and regard it as an opportunity to learn more about our own negative emotions, then that situation of being insulted will become beneficial to us. And that is the best way to respond when one is insulted.
Then,
Roger Sigma, the Yamanji, Yabotos, and Dosha was.
但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的钱才是动案的这个程序的但是你们当官的是这个说是做的
Sometimes we have some find difficult to get
I don't think the sixth verse needs a particular commentary. And the seventh verse says, when others the seventh verse says, even if someone I had benefited and had great hopes, in short, whether it be indirectly or directly, offer benefits and happiness to all mother sentient beings, and may I in return discreetly receive all harm and sufferings of mother sentient beings. By all these aspirations, this is the eighth verse now, by all these aspirations, remaining undefiled by the eight worldly concerns, and by recognizing all phenomena as illusion, may I, without clinging and attachment, be liberated from bondage. So these verses are a culmination of the meaning of the previous verses. One of the most well-renowned masters of the mind training tradition was the great master Chekawa Yeshe Dorje, who composed the very famous text, The Seven Points of Mind Training. And it is said that when Chekawa Yeshe Dorje was young, he heard about Geshe Langri Tangpa's text, the eight verses of mind training, and he overheard people chanting the text. And this caused him to feel great interest and reverence towards the Kadampa tradition, which eventually became a cause for him entering into that tradition. So at a young age, he was able to memorize the words of the eight verses. And by his own reports, he said, Chekawa Yeshe Dorje said, I didn't reach a deep level of practice in relation to the eight verses of mind training, but I did receive a lot of benefit from contemplating these teachings. At the time of Chikawayeshe Dorje, the roadways and transportation routes in Tibet were much more difficult. There weren't cars and so forth, and the roads and pathways and so on were fewer. And so there was also a rougher environment where if you were traveling on foot, you might encounter bandits and thieves and so on. So Chikawayeshe Dorje shares that at these times when he encountered bandits or thieves, the teachings from the 8 verses on mind training helped pacify the fear in his mind. So he was less overcome by fear in these situations. And similarly, sometimes when traveling about, he had trouble finding a place to stay overnight. And on those situations where he couldn't find a place to stay, instead of feeling disappointed, he would think to himself, "This is wonderful." And he would practice the teachings from the mind training text that he had memorized. And so in this way, he reported receiving great benefit from the 8 verses of training the mind. So, I think that one of the main reasons why mind training texts are conveyed in short, pithy verses is because it makes them easy to remember and easy to memorize so that they can be used as a day-to-day support for our practice. And the words of the teachings, as well as the meaning of those teachings, can be brought to mind readily on a day-to-day basis in all kinds of different situations. And therefore, I am happy to have had a chance to explain all 8 verses of this text to you today.